Hello and welcome to this video on clustering words or tweets with R. In this video, we are going to take a look at how to read text file, and this text file is going to be containing tweets. And then we build corpus. Corpus means collection of documents. So in fact, each tweet will be treated as a single document. And then we create term document matrix from that corpus. So term document matrix means we identify each and every term in those tweets or documents, and then we count how many times each word appears in each tweet. So once we create this term document matrix, we also create a plot of most frequent terms followed by hierarchical word or tweet clustering using dendrogram. So earlier we had used dendrogram for numerical data. Now we are going to do this for tweets, followed by non-hierarchical k-means clustering of words or tweets. So let's get started by reading the file. For this analysis, I'm going to need a library called TM. TM stands for text mining. So if you have not installed this package, then we need to go to install and install TM. Once this is done, we run this library, and I'm going to set my working directory to my desktop where my file is. And then we use this command read lines. So this can be used when our file is a text file, tweets.txt. So that's why I'm using read lines. If this is a CSV file, then we say read.csv. So let's store this in tweets. So you'll notice that there are 2141 tweets. If you want to look at them, you can simply run this tweets, and each and every tweet will be listed here. So it may omit some of the tweet because of reaching a maximum print limit, but all 2141 tweets will be there. Now let us build corpus, and we are going to store this in corpus itself. The function is corpus for corpus, and we'll make use of vector source and tweets. So now this corpus is ready with 2141 tweets. Now let's create term document matrix. Let's store this in TDM. TDM for term document matrix, but you can give any name you like. And the function we use is called term document matrix. So we feed the corpus that we have created just now, and we'll also use this control. So we can say minimum word length equals something between 1 and infinity. That means it will contain everything, but we can also restrict this minimum word length using this control feature. So let's run this. So now term document matrix is created. If you simply select TDM and run this, it will give you some information that there are 6,934 terms in 2,141 documents or tweets. And it's a very sparse matrix, like lot of these cells are zeros. So sparsity is very high. So what we can do is, if you want to reduce the sparsity, we can say remove sparse terms. So in this TDM, we can specify sparse equals, let's say 0.98, and we can store this new term document matrix in T. So if you look at T now, you can see number of terms have come down and sparsity is about 93%. So there's some improvement. Depending on the data that we have, we can always play with this number to cut down on sparsity. So once we are okay with what we have, so let's convert this T into a matrix and store in M so that we can do further analysis. So now let's plot frequent terms. Let me store this in frequency, FREQ, and I'm going to do row sums of m. Because it has many words, like more than 100, so if we plot all of them, it is going to be a very busy graph. To cut down on that, what we can do is, we can say that our FREQ is in fact a subset of, where FREQ is more than or equal to 50. So any word that has appeared more than 50 times, only that will be included. So now let's make a bar plot. So I'm going to use some features. So I'm going to keep less at 2, and color, we'll borrow color from rainbow. So we get this colorful bar plot where different words are listed on the x-axis and the frequency is on the y-axis. So obviously it can also be cleaned up. So we are not going into details of that. So once you have identified what keywords you want to include, we can go to the next step, which is create a dendrogram. To create a dendrogram, we make use of dist function to first find distance, and we'll use scale to normalize and m. So our matrix is m, and let's store this distance in distance. If you want to see this, we can say print distance and with digits, let's use 2. So what it will do is, it will print different words and also like calculate the distance between the words in each document. If the distance is high, that means those two words should not be in the same cluster. If distance is quite low, then that suggests that the words should be in the same cluster. Once we have calculated distance, we can do hierarchical clustering, CLUST, using this distance. And the method we are going to use is called WARDWARD dot capital D. And let's store this in HC for hierarchical clustering. So we can run this. When this is done, we can plot this. So this is the cluster dendrogram, quite busy because there are many words. So this is more clear. So now you see that this is the distance and some words are hanging up in the air. So what we can do is, we can align everything by doing comma hang equals -1. So this looks much better. So we see some clusters here, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So in fact, more than 10 clusters. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put a red rectangle around about 10 clusters, and that we can do by using a command RECT rectangle dot HC clust. So our clusters are in HC, and let's say we want to identify or group the outcome into 10 clusters. So now if you look at dendrogram again, so this is a huge cluster. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. This has a single element, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's increase this to 12 and run these two lines again. So now that huge cluster is broken into one more, and you see now 12 clusters. Now to do non-hierarchical k-means clustering, we need to first create a transpose of the M matrix that we are using. We'll call this as M1. So you can do transpose of a matrix by just using T. So transpose means rows become columns and column become rows. Let's fix a seed so that what I get here, you also get exactly same pattern. For K means, I'm going to assign a number 12, like we want 12 clusters. So we'll store the results of K means clustering in KC. So we use M1 and K. If you want to look at the outcome, I'm going to select KC and run. So it will give the output. It shows that the 12 clusters have sizes of like 652, 116 and so on. So it gives you size of each cluster and also cluster means. So for all the 12 clusters and for each word that we are analyzing, we get the averages. So high average means that word has appeared in that particular cluster with higher frequency. So for example, this one is 1.05. So this is the highest for this column. So this has appeared with higher frequency in cluster 8. And then you have clustering vector. So first one has gone to cluster 1, second one to cluster 1, third one has gone to cluster 10 and so on. So each of the 1141 entries also have information about what cluster they have gone to. And then for all the 12 clusters, we have within cluster sum of squares, and then between sum of squares divided by the total sum of squares is about 33.8%. So we want these numbers to be lower and we want this number to be higher. So these numbers will be lower if within cluster variability is low. That means the elements in each clusters are closer to each other. And this number will be high when cluster to cluster differences or distances are higher. So clusters are separated from each other more and more will lead to higher value. So this is 33.8. Let's see if we go to only 3 cluster, what happens. So you can see clusters to cluster distances or variability changes. We want actually clusters to be separated with bigger distances, but that's not happening if we go to only 3 clusters. And in fact, within cluster also has a lot of variability. You can see these numbers are quite high. So you have values up to almost 6,000. If you look at the previous one with 12 clusters, so the highest value I see is about 2,599, so much below 6,000. And most of the other values are close to 500 or 700 and so on. So with 3 clusters within cluster variability has in fact increased. So that's not good. And also between cluster distances don't seem to have improved with 3 clusters. So that's why the percentage has come down. So this is how we can vary K and see the outcome and choose a value of K which is going to work for us.